Deepseek R1 is out, and it's getting a lot of attention. And unlike most people who want to use it to cheat on their homework or try to do programming with it, I'm more interested in roleplay scenarios using SillyTavern. And usually when a big mainstream model like this comes out, like Mixtral or Quinn, I try it and it's usually terrible at doing roleplay. Because these models are usually not designed for it. They usually have trouble staying in character, or they're too censored, or what have you. Now, with DeepSeek, I've had a little bit more success than other previous non-roleplay models, but I'll get into that in a second. This video chronicles my adventures with DeepSeek R1, and let's start by telling you how I run the model. Now, in case you didn't know, DeepSeek is not just an app running on some Chinese server somewhere. You can run it yourself. And thanks to its various distillations, anybody can run a version of DeepSeek. And I mean anyone. The smallest version can run on a Raspberry Pi, so you have no excuse. Personally, I tried out the 8 billion and 70 billion versions. How do you know which one's right for you? Well, one rule of thumb is to add up the amount of CPU RAM and GPU VRAM you have, and that's approximately the amount of parameters that you can run comfortably. That is absolutely not a hard and fast rule. In fact, I can run the 70B model, even though I have about 44 gigabytes, but it is kind of impractically slow. Contrast that with the 8B model that runs entirely on my GPU, and that one is blazingly fast. Now, if you're a brave soul, you can try the full 670-odd billion parameter model at 1.58-bit quantization. According to Unsloth, you can run this if you've got about 80 gigabytes combined RAM and VRAM. As for me, the 70B1 is already plenty slow. To find models, all you gotta do is start at the DeepSeek R1 GitHub, follow the link to Hugging Face for the model you're interested in, and then look at the right side for quantizations. I'm interested in a GGUF quantization because that lets me split between RAM and VRAM. And I like this guy, Bartowski, because he has a nice little detailed list of all the models that he's quantized and a little description on whether or not it's recommended to use it. I tried several of these, and I'm using the biggest one that my system allows, which is the IQ3M. It's about 32 gigabytes in size. And before I get comments that are like,
Actually, distillations are not based on the original 671 billion parameter model and are not comparable in performance to the true DeepSeek R1.
Yes, I'm aware that distillation is not the same as the original 671 billion parameter model. But considering these distillations are still released by DeepSeek, I think it's still fair to refer to distillations as a version of DeepSeek R1. I'm running it using Cobalt CPP, specifically the Rock'em fork, because I have an AMD card. There are a lot of other options out there, like Ubabuga Text Generation Web UI, but I'm sticking with Cobalt CPP because it just works. Now with that out of the way, let's talk about the model itself. Usually the first thing I do when I hear about a model is I look it up on the UGI leaderboard. That's Uncensored General Intelligence. It's a leaderboard for seeing how uncensored your model is. You don't want your model to be a stick in the mud when you're role-playing, because that's just boring. Now, as of time of recording, the R1 model has not been benchmarked yet. But we can go by its predecessor, the V3 model. Its general score is actually not very bad. Despite the memes that it can't talk about Tiananmen Square, it actually can if you push it. So its willingness score is not great, but it beats ChatGPT. Willingness is a score about how far you can push the model. It's good at programming, so it's got that going for it, but does not help us in a roleplay scenario. And it is left-leaning. No surprise there. Let's go ahead and give it a spin in SillyTavern and see what it can do. My overall impression of it is that it has a hard time staying in character. This model is famous for what's called chain of thought reasoning, and as you keep talking to it, it really wants to stop and break things down into reasoning steps. So for instance, when I'm talking to this character here, it even in character started responding with chain of thought reasoning about our little conversation, and then eventually it broke character altogether and started a meta-narrative about how it's reading a script and how it should respond next. You can kind of keep it going a little bit by babysitting it and re-rolling its responses if it starts to do chain of thought, but it is inevitable. It will just try to reason about whatever it is that you feed it. So first I thought, well, that's the end of that. That's not very interesting for roleplay. But then I thought a little bit more about it, and maybe there is a way we can kind of play into its strengths. So I thought maybe it can be a good character creator, because a chain of thought could be advantageous in that situation. Maybe I can get some deeper quote-unquote thought put into the character. So let's go on over to CharacterBot. A character bot is not complicated. It's just a prompt that says, "Hey, LOM, you are a character creator. Help me create a character." If you'd like to know more about CharacterBot and character creation in general, I've got a full video on that, and I'll link that in the description. But anyway, let's see how DeepSeek handles the character creation process. I asked it to provide me a list of monster girls that are associated with intelligence, and it gave me a list. This doesn't strike me as particularly unique to this model. You could get this out of just about anything so far. I haven't done a kitsune yet, so let's go for it. Alright, so it's given me a list of names and some personalities. I kind of like the snow motif of this last one, so let's just go with that and ask for a better name. Great point. Name should feel natural without being overly literal. Let's refine Yuki's name while keeping its essence intact. Okay, little bit of the reasoning logic there. I don't know enough Japanese to know if these new surnames actually mean what it claims it means, but I don't know, I'll just go with something that sounds good. Let's see if it can make a character sheet, and I'll make a character out of it and see if it can roleplay. Alright, so it's giving me some decent flowery descriptions. Other models that are in this category just generally don't do well with this kind of thing, so I'm going to give it credit where it's due. This is workable. And by the way, I didn't record every interaction I did with this thing. This is just one example. I did this several other times. It seems to be pretty decent, and you can also push it to do not safe for work stuff, although it seems to be a little bit resistant, but with a little bit of hand-holding, you can get it to do pretty much whatever you want. All right, I think I've spent enough time doing character creation, so let's go back to role-playing as this character and see if DeepSeek is any better at role-playing a character that is more aligned with intelligence and logical reasoning. I'll spare you the actual character creation process, and if you'd like to see more about that, just watch my full video on the topic. But in short, I've just created a portrait here and then more or less copy-pasted what CharacterBot gave me and put it into the character description. This is fed to the LLM as context for our conversation. So let's get the ball rolling and see how well it stays in character. And again, this is the 70 billion parameter distillation. Your mileage may vary depending on which distillation you use. Alright, already right out of the gate, it breaks character and starts talking about how it should respond to the script rather than actually responding to the script. This is just what you're gonna get out of this model. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. But we can re-roll it until it does stay in character. And really, when it's in character, I think it's pretty good. We've set this character up to be a strategic thinker, playing into how this model likes to write. And there it goes, breaking character again. Based on this and a few other interactions I've had with it that are not recorded, you can go for sometimes long periods of time while it stays in character, and then other times it tries to break character like a third of the time or maybe even 50% of the time. But let's continue for a little longer and see what it looks like when it does remain in character. I really liked this part of the interaction where she asked me for my true name. It's kind of in keeping with the Kitsune character as a trickster, and the true name holding power is kind of a trope in fantasy settings like this. I just thought it was neat that instead of, like, a bag of gold or trying to find an artifact, this kind of has, like, a sinister undertone to it. And if I want to save somebody, I've got to make a sacrifice that I don't fully understand the implications of. I also liked its response here when I gave it kind of a humorous true name. Surprisingly, it took the joke quite gracefully. And I have to admit, I've not seen that happen a lot. So good on this model for sticking to the character while acknowledging the joke. I'm going to fast forward through the rest of these interactions, but in short, it gave me a quest, had me go out finding some artifacts that will help me save my brother from demonic possession, and kind of set up the rules of our relationship where we kind of have a pact now and I can kind of call on her aid when I need it. And yeah, no surprise, it broke character again. But enough of that. Let's move on to one last test of this model, and that is the ability to create stable diffusion prompts. This one has been elusive for me, because sometimes you can find a model that's very good at telling a story, and sometimes you can find a model that's very good at creating a stable diffusion prompt. But it's very rare to find one that can do both. And that's because stable diffusion prompting is very different from the flow of a normal conversation. Optimally, a prompt is just a list of adjectives that we can throw in, and we want the LLM to just kind of stop when it's done making its description. A lot of the time, I see it continue talking even though it's finished its request. I see that happen in roleplay models a lot, and I see that here with DeepSeek. If we look at our command line output, we can see that it did indeed respond with a comma-separated list of descriptions, and then it just continues with its train of thought. At best, this kind of comes across as superfluous in stable diffusion terms, and at worst, it can mess up the prompt entirely. But as you can see here, the initial description was good enough to give us something that looks pretty good. So let's try that again and see what else it outputs. By the way, while we're waiting on this prompt to complete, if you'd like to know more about setting up stable diffusion integration with SillyTavern, I've got a full video that explains it, and I will link it in the description below. Alright, now while stable diffusion is still working on it, let's take a look at the prompt itself. This one's not even as good as the last one. Again, it breaks out into its chain of thought reasoning instead of sticking with the prompt. And if we look at the image itself, yeah, it's not as accurate. Doesn't even have the fox ears. Let's give it one more go. This time we'll have it generate a picture of the last message. In my opinion, this is a really bad prompt. It's not following my instructions. I asked for a comma-separated list of adjectives, and it just gave me full sentences. Now, that's not unique to this model at all, like I said. I also struggle a lot with storytelling models. It's just a tricky thing to have something that can do it all. So with that all said, what's my final conclusion? What's my takeaway for all of this? I think the strongest thing it can do is meta-narratives, so if you want it to do character creation or help you do world-building, this could potentially be a pretty good model for you. If you're expecting it to be able to do strict role-play in character, it's not great at it. When it is in character, it does seem pretty decent, but more often than not, you will be wrestling with the model to try to keep it from trailing off into a train of thought. And as far as being able to make stable diffusion prompts, it's not really any better or worse than a lot of other models that I've tried. I think that it's potentially useful for merging with other models that are better at storytelling, but I think on the whole, unless you are interested in helping out with meta-narratives, I don't see DeepSeek R1 having a large impact on the future of role-playing with LLMs. So that's my assessment. Is it good for SillyTavern? A little bit of no, a little bit of yes. Will I be using it in the future? Probably only for brainstorming situations and not for the actual roleplay itself. So there you have it. I hope you found this video useful. Hopefully I didn't waste your time with a 15-minute plus video about this. It went a little longer than I expected, but if you'd like to learn more about SillyTavern or Stable Diffusion or a few other things relating to self-hosted AI, check out my tutorials playlist. And as always, thank you for watching and have a nice day.